Welcome to this North Atlantic Conference women's lacrosse matchup between the Husson University Eagles and the Northern Vermont Lyndon Hornets. I'm Avery Henningsen alongside Sam Miller here at Boucher Field in Bangor, Maine on the Husson Eagles Sports Network. This will be the last regular season home game of the season for the Eagles and the last home game for seniors Sophia Gomez and Devin Vietz. It's a special day out on the field for those two, Sam.
Absolutely, Avery. Both of these players, come natives of Massachusetts, come to Husson, and they have definitely made a very big impact on this team. And you know, it's going to be great to see what they accomplish. We're going to see what they've accomplished throughout their 4 years at Husson, and you know, what a great way to just honor them after all they've done.
Yeah, both players, seniors for the squad, very key contributors in the midfield, both defensively and offensively. For Husson, I know Vietz yesterday came away with 5 goals in that contest, kind of getting the senior weekend festivities kicking off out there. But we'll hand it over here in just a second to Joseph Swanson, the PA for the senior ceremony and the national anthem, along with the starting lineups.
Welcome to Boucher Field for today's matchup between the Hornets of Northern Vermont University-Lyndon and your Husson University Eagles. At this time, we'd like to take a moment and honor our seniors, Sophia Gomez and David Vietz, for their contributions to the women's lacrosse program. Our first senior is number 11, Sophia Gomez. A 4-year member of the Husson women's lacrosse program, Sophia has scored 47 goals and recorded 6 assists for a total of 53 points. The senior attacker has secured 60 draw controls, 68 ground balls, and has caused 39 turnovers. Sophia will be graduating with her bachelor's degree in psychology. She is joined today by her parents, Amy and Lewis Goodman. Our next senior is number 21, Devin Vietz. In her 3-year career with the women's lacrosse team, Devin has amassed 29 goals and 8 assists for a total of 37 points. The senior midfielder has caused 36 turnovers in her career, including a single game record of 8 against Thomas College on April 8th. Additionally, Devin has scooped up 78 ground balls and won 44 draw controls in her career. Devin will be graduating with a bachelor's degree in biology. She is joined today by her parents, Anne-Marie and Mark, and Riley, Mason, and Jude. Yes, there are 2 Masons joining Devin. Thank you, Devin and Sophia, for all you have done for the Husson Women's Lacrosse. Our program is better today because of you. Let's have another round of applause for our 2 Husson seniors. Fans, it is time. Let's meet the starting lineups for today's game. First, for the visiting Hornets, a sophomore defender, number 8, Isabel Bourgeois. A freshman defender, number 10, Libby Webb. A sophomore defender, number 11, Mary Grace Weissauer. A senior goaltender, number 13, Rachel Palladino. A sophomore attacker, number 18, Alexis Leroy. A sophomore attacker, number 20, Joanna Parker. A sophomore attacker, number 26, Mika Krul. And a freshman defender, number 30, Kiana Mack. Lyndon is coached by Ben Wurzler. And now, let's meet the starting lineup for your Husson University Eagles. A freshman from Winslow, Maine, number 2, Madison Lauer. A sophomore from High Park, Vermont, number 5, Maddie Benoit. A sophomore from Georgia, Vermont, number 7, Sydney Heath. A freshman from Augusta, Maine, number 8, Emma Doran. A senior from Chelsea, Massachusetts, number 11, Sophia Gomez. A sophomore from Reedfield, Maine, number 14, Natalie Whitten. A sophomore from Concord, New Hampshire, number 15, Jordan Lingle. A junior from Richmond, Rhode Island, number 17, Montana Carrier. A senior from Tewksbury, Massachusetts, number 21, Bevan Veets. In goal, a sophomore from Lewiston, Maine, number 22, Emma Begin. A sophomore from Bucksport, Maine, number 23, Lacey Scanlon. And a freshman from Corona, Maine, number 24, Jory Boyd. The Eagles are coached by Amanda DeHayes, and she's assisted by Caitlin Dolloff. Fans, at this time, we ask you please rise and honor America with a playing of our national anthem. NCAA North Atlantic Conference at Husson University to promote good sportsmanship by the student athletes, coaches, and spectators of today's contest. We request your cooperation by supporting participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial, or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated or actually removed from the field.
And that was the national anthem, along with the senior ceremony and starting lineups. And we are about to get underway here in just a few moments. Last couple things here. The Eagles enter this one at 6-4 after dropping a hard-fought loss to the reigning NAC champion SUNY Canton yesterday. While Lyndon is 0-6 on the season after losing to Maine Maritime 22-0 in the same yesterday as well. Sam, Lyndon has dealt with injuries this season and only have 8 players on the roster for this game. Here at Husson, how do you handle that as a team?
Well, if I'm Lyndon right now, it's got to be a next moment up mentality. I mean, obviously, you've been dealing with injuries all year, and you're going up against a very talented Eagles squad. So, intensity, next moment up, it's got to be key here for the Hornets.
Yeah, and we'll see how they line up out there. I'm going to guess it will be somewhat defensive-minded, as they won't obviously be able to sort of man all those positions out there. You're going to be four players down on the field for the entirety of it. I'm sure if the score were to get out of hand, we might see a little bit of sportsmanship from Husson taking a few players off the field to make it a little bit even strength. But at the same time, the Eagles played player down for most of last season, and it didn't really work out. And Vietz is going to come away with that draw control by Sophia Gomez, the two seniors right off the bat there, as they get their final home game underway here. That one is scooped up by Witten on the far side. And defensively, they will have a pretty full group out there that pretty much all these players will have to play offense and defense. As Vietz is going to take a little shot there over the top of that crossbar.
Yeah, going back to your point, Avery, looks like Lyndon is very secure as Lingle gets that goal in. It looks like they're going to have to play a lot more defensively minded today because offense might be a little bit of a struggle.
And that is Lengel's first goal of her career here at Husson. Obviously, Lengel in her first season for the Eagles, one of those Husson basketball players, but we'll take another look back at that big moment for her.
Yeah, right off the bat there, Avery, we saw the goal. Saw that come right in from Lengel. Covered into the middle of the field, got a wide open goal, used her height to her advantage there, snuck it right in, and gives the Eagles the early lead.
A great job by her to get the Eagles on the board early. And the Eagles starting this game with a little bit different lineup than we've seen for a lot of the season. I think Coach DeHaze is trying to get some players in who haven't started as many games this season. And right there, they're making an impact already in this one. As that one's going to be won by Mack. And we'll see how Lyndon handles offense right off the bat here. This one will be pushed over to the far sideline. Picked up by Leroy out there. And the Eagles are going to drop back into a little bit of a defensive shell. It looks like Lyndon's going to keep two players back on defense. This will be taken around the backside by Lyndon. As that one gets knocked down by Begin there in goal. And it's going to be a little fight for the ball there in the middle. But it's going to be... It's kind of tossed around there, right around the goal, and it's going to be the Eagles who are going to come away with it. I believe that was Scanlon out there who was the one who picked it up. Pass up to Gomez. She finds freshman Madison Lauer out there over towards Witten, and Witten's going to take a shot right off the goalkeeper's stick there. As I think the Eagles will have a lot of success in transition in this one. They're going to be player up out there as a lot of players for Lyndon have moved up. The Eagles can just kind of leave players on offense.
Absolutely, Avery. And that's not good for Lyndon as fast as this Eagle team plays. They love to run out. They love to get in transition. So they're going to have to pick that up very quickly for the Hornets.
But if Lyndon can have time to kind of fall back into a defensive shell, they'll be at full strength on defense. But this Eagles offense is still very dominant out there as Vietz takes one right off the post there, very nearly netting a goal there for the Eagles. This will be number 10, Libby Webb with it. She's going to send it over towards Isabelle Bourgeois. A pass back to Mack, and she's going to scoop it back up. She finds Webb as the Eagles are going to try to pin Lyndon here in this corner and try to take it away in the midfield. And the Eagles will have the ball on offense now. This is Gomez with the ball. Gomez is going to take it herself inside just over the top of the crossbar. The Eagles already have had some very close shots in this one.
Yeah, couldn't have said it better, Avery. When Gomez got the ball, scooped it right up, she ran right across the middle. Had a good look for a shot, but just overshot it by a little bit.
This will be taken into the middle over towards Vietz. Vietz finds Lengel. Lengel sends a pass towards Doran. Another pass, kind of just a little shovel shot there by Lauer, but knocked away by the goalkeeper.
Good play there by 13, Rachel Palladino, to prevent the goal for the Hornets there. We'll see what the Hornets do, how they can respond.
And Palladino, trying to get that ball out, sends a pass high over the top and Witten with the ball now. Whitten into Lauer. She loses control of that one, but manages to pick it back up again. And she's going to get a free position attempt here for the Eagles. Lauer also still trying to net that first goal of her young Husson career. Lauer's going to take this one inside, knocked away. I think we'll see a foul on that one. She got hit in that backswing.
Yeah, it looks like number 30 for the Hornets, Kiara Mack, came right from behind and caught it from behind right there. So she'll get a second chance for this free possession.
Lauer takes this one right into the goalkeeper's stick. She tried to go right on her, but seen out there by Palladino. As the Hornets give the ball away again in the midfield, they're struggling to get the ball out defensively.
Yeah, it just seems like for the last 3 to 4 minutes, Husson has just sit on the offensive and are just have multiple opportunities to look for a goal.
As Gomez takes a shot there right into the goalkeeper, as Palladino's already up to several saves in this one. I know looking at the stats from Lyndon's game yesterday against Maine Maritime, they were only successful on 17 of their 45 clear attempts versus Maine Maritime being successful on 33 of 36. And this Eagles midfield has been known this season to be very aggressive out there. As a pass from Benoit inside missed there by Vietz. The great pass inside there from Benoit.
Yeah, great vision there from Benoit to find Vietz, but just overshot it by a little bit. And looks like the Hornets are going to regain possession here.
As we'll see what the penalty is on that one. Seems that the referees are conferring out there. As the Eagles have, outside of that one offensive possession from Lyndon, the Eagles have been on offense for the entirety of this game. Even when they miss shots or turn the ball over, they're just not even allowing Lyndon to get the ball up the field at all.
Yeah, it's really tough when you're Lyndon, when you have a chance to get on offense, but if you're the goalkeeper, Palladino, trying to find anyone to pass to, you're swarmed by the many women on Husson who are, as you said, every woman up this game.
Yeah, and in the stat sheet, these two teams are technically at even strength, but on the field, it is definitely kind of showing out there that the players for Lyndon are just playing, they're playing from behind. You have four less players than the other team. The Eagles defense is really just kind of standing out there watching the offense do their thing. As this will be a pass over to Whitten. Whitten inside, trying to find Gomez. Over the top of her head. We'll see if that one, I think it's going to slow down just in time. Scooped up by Lauer. Lauer sends a pass into Doran. Kind of knocked around and picked up by Mack for Lyndon.
Checking in for the Eagles, we got number 4, Abigail Booth, and number 6, Emma Romadzik.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if the Eagles have a lot of substitutions, as there goes Baker and Martinez, two of the Eagles' leading goal scorers who didn't start this one, but I think we'll see a lot of substitutions as this one, as Baker getting it started right off the bat, sends the ball over the top to Martinez. Those two having started every game for the Eagles on the season, getting the rest to start this one off, but they are still out there on the field. As Lengel into Gomez. Gomez with a shot on senior day. Nets her goal in this one.
Yeah, going back to that play, Avery. Just gather there from the midfielder. Cut across the middle. Finds Gomez coming right across. Beautiful shot. Put the Eagles up by 2.
And that's Gomez's 18th goal of the season as she gets a goal on her senior day. That one definitely feels special for her out there. And in the middle now for Gomez versus Mac on that draw control. And this one's going to get popped up to Gomez, who's going to take that one cleanly herself. She sends a pass up towards Baker. Baker goes inside, gets it poked away, though, by Lyndon. We'll see as that's Vietz who's going to take it eventually for the Eagles. As the senior goal scorer, Gomez, with the ball now. She's just looking for someone to pass to out there. She finds Martinez in the middle of the field. Martinez is going to go right and take a shot right off the post there on that one. It's going to just bounce its way out towards Scanlon in the deep defensive midfield. As this will be picked up by Baker. Baker with a pass over the top to Martinez, who tries to get control of that one, but I don't think she quite had enough time to really get a shot on net there.
Yeah, great recognition there by Baker to find Martinez coming across the middle. Just couldn't gather herself and shoot that.
As Doran sends a pass into Vietz, but Vietz can't manage to quite control that one. I think she was more just trying to shovel that in. As Baker runs into some hard contact in the middle of the field, she hits in to Kiara Mack. And Kiara Mack's going to get a yellow card on that one, and we'll go to the sideline for the penalty, and the Eagles will now be five players up out there on the field.
Yeah, that's the last thing you want to see if you're the Hornets, having someone, especially like Mack, who's a very good defender for this Lyndon team, when you're already down so many people.
And it will be Baker taking this free position. And it will be Baker here, set to take this free position shot. 8 of 20 on the season. Make that 9 of 21 as she makes it 3-0 for the Eagles off of the foul.
Yeah, this is something we've grown accustomed to seeing over the course of the season. Watch how Baker explodes off this line. As soon as the whistle goes, see her take off, goes right towards the goal, shoots it low, helps extend this Eagles lead.
Baker's 33rd goal of her rookie season. A great job so far by her. She had a slow game against Thomas, picked it back up again yesterday. She had some key goals in that one. The Eagles in that game yesterday, that was a fun one to watch as they were down for a while and then kind of came back late in that one. But just couldn't quite manage to overcome the lead that Canton got out to in that third quarter.
Absolutely. And to your point about Avery Baker, yesterday she was held relatively quiet, did not score yesterday, so that goal that she just had, it's got to feel pretty good.
As Vietz is going to pick this one up on the far end line. Sends this one over towards Baker. Baker into Martinez, catches it cleanly off of the goalkeeper on that one. As the goalkeeper's done quite a good job in this one of stopping the Eagles from running the score up any higher than it already is.
Absolutely, and the Eagles have had some really good shots, and they've had good shots, they've been there, but the goalkeeper, credit to Paula Dino, she's been able to cap on helping the Eagles send their lead.
That will be a shot wide there for the Eagles. Looks like they're going to maintain possession of the ball, though. Max back out there. Gomez with it now at the top. She tries to find Lengel off of her stick, though. But the Eagles will get possession of the ball back. This one's sent over towards Vietz. Vietz onto the backside, pass into the middle now. That's Lauer with it, who's going to take that shot and get the first goal of her Husson career. That makes it two first goals of careers in this game so far.
Yeah, going back to that play, Avery, just great ball movement all around. Lauer just working around the field, gets the ball, shoots it right through, and the Eagles are up by 4.
Yeah, great job by Lauer. She had a chance earlier in this one, but couldn't capitalize on it. But she does not miss on that one. Baker now with a goal and an assist in some limited minutes out there. The Eagles now have 4 different goal scorers in this one.
Yeah, the thing that makes the Eagles scary, Avery, going back to that Lauer goal, is that this team is young, they're exciting, and they've got so much depth going forward. The rest of the season, they're going to be fun to watch. As well as for the next few years, they are going to be a threat in this conference.
This one's picked up by Martinez. Martinez with some room in front of her. Tries to send a pass into the middle, but knocked down there. And it looks like it will be Vietz who's going to come in there and clean that one up, scoop it up. She finds Baker. Baker catches it, takes a shot just wide of the left post there on that one. But like you were saying, the Eagles have a lot of young talent. You have Baker and Martinez, the two freshmen who've contributed so much on offense. Then you also have some other key freshman contributors out there, and Lauer and Doran, along with several, Lauer and Doran out there, and then that key sophomore group as well.
Absolutely. You got people like Sydney Heth, and number five, Maddie Benoit, two players who make an impact offensively and defensively. This Eagles team is going to be very scary in the future.
Yeah, along with Witten, who's only one assist away from tying the program record for assists in a season for the Eagles. Along with both of their goalkeepers, that is. But the Eagles are going to have some talent out there for several years to come. Obviously, they'll be missing Vietz and Gomez next season, but they'll also have some key contributors coming back to this squad.
Absolutely, and right on cue, we have number seven, Sydney Heth, and number five, Maddie Benoit, checking in for the Eagles.
There'll be a green card there assessed to freshman Madison Lauer down there. It'll be Lyndon with the ball. There'll be technically a woman up out there. It'll more just be they're only down three players instead of four on the field.
Yeah, this is what seems like their first offensive possession, and I think about, I want to say, five or six minutes. The Eagles have really been controlling the pace on offense, so we'll see if the Hornets can get something to go here.
There's about 4 minutes left in this first quarter of play. Heth is going to pick that one up as she forced that turnover right there. Tries to send a ball up towards Baker. Baker working against Leroy, and she's going to win possession of that one. Witten with it now, and this is that dangerous transition we talked about. As Witten's going to slow it down, let the offense come in. Will allow the Hornets to get some players back on defense, though. As there's a shot there from Gomez as she gets her second goal of the contest. And that will tie that program record for Witten as she assisted that ball.
Yeah, going back to that last play, Avery, just another great look for Witten right there. Finds Gomez for a second goal of the day. Got to feel good for her on senior day.
Gomez, a native of Chelsea, Massachusetts, majoring in psychology here at Husson. That's her 47th goal of her career, or her 49th goal of her career here at Husson. She's done a great job contributing for them in the midfield and on offense, as she's going to get set for a draw control possession here.
Great to say to Betty Ravery. She has definitely impacted this Eagles team for a very long time. Excellent in the midfield. Great on the offensive. Her impact's definitely been felt here over the course of her career.
As Vietz is going to have all day to scoop that one up. She's going to send a pass over towards Benoit. This one's sent into Witten. Witten's going to lose possession of it, but picked up by Martinez. Martinez to the backside. She's going to send it over towards Witten. And Witten forces the shooting space penalty on that one, and she'll get a free position attempt coming up on this. And Witten's going to take this one inside, get the goal for her as she nets her first of the contest.
Yeah, if you're going back to that last play, we talked about how exceptional Witten's passing has been, but here she is showing her greatness towards the goal. Lines right up, takes off towards the goal, lays in the picture, perfect shot, puts the Eagles up again.
That is her 22nd of the season for the Eagles, and it is now a 6-0 lead in this first quarter for the Eagles. course, in women's lacrosse, once we get to 10 goals, it will be running clock for the rest of the game. So we'll see if the Eagles get there. As this will be Gomez against Mack out there. As this one's going to be popped up towards the backside. Mack with the first chance at it, but loses it to Gomez. Gomez tries to find a pass up top, and it will eventually find its way into the stick of Avery Baker. Baker going inside herself, and she takes this one right off the goalkeeper's stick. Another great save out there from Pauladino. Pauladino up to 9 saves in this game already. Be a pass given onto the backside. That one's sent inside towards Lauer as she manages to scoop it up, but is forced to back it out to the offense. Martinez is going to lose it there, but it looks like Gomez almost gets it, but gets called for the penalty. And now Lyndon, a little bit of charge up this left far sideline of the field. They try to send a pass, and Baker might have didn't manage to quite get it cleanly, but she tries to take it up the middle, and I think she's going to get fouled on that one, and we'll get a free position attempt coming up here from the outer edge of that arc.
Got to respect the defensive effort there for Alexis Leroy for the Hornets. Tried slowing down Avery Baker coming down the field, and just didn't turn out her way.
Looks like she'll actually just get a live penalty. She sends a pass into V2, gets her senior goal of the day as the Eagles set that one up perfectly.
Yeah, we talk about Baker and her explosiveness on offense, but she's shown this season that she's a very all-around balanced player. Great, just as good as passing as it is, as you see right here. Finds V2, cutting across the left side, gets it right in. Eagles up by 6.
And a great shot there from Vietz. Kind of saw that one coming. She was on that backside, kind of all alone. Saw Baker look over at her and then just snuck in behind the goalkeeper. And that's a great goal for the Eagles. 7-0 now. Vietz gets her 16th of the season and her first of this senior day contest. This one's going to get popped up by Gomez. And it'll be Martinez who's going to come away with it. Martinez is going to slow this one down and take it out to the backside. Pass in towards Lauer. Lauer can't manage to quite control it, but picks it up on the second bounce. She finds Baker who goes around, loops to that back upper corner of the net, and gets her second of the contest. Eagles goal, number one. A nice little run there from Baker to take that one around the backside.
Yeah, going back to it, Avery. Baker's this is her bread and butter. One on one is her game. Beats by the defender, gets a nice little goal, and helps extend the Eagles' lead.
Yeah, and I'm sure it feels great for Baker out there to not be man marked on every possession that she has the ball. On that one, she showed why teams have been going to that strategy against her. She got a little bit of space and was able to take it inside, kind of fake the goalkeeper out to that upper right side, and then went upper left with it. As Gomez versus Mack in the middle here again, and it will be knocked around and eventually picked up by Vietz on that one. So I'm sure Lyndon is already starting to get tired in this one. Under a minute left in this first quarter. Pass to Baker. As Gomez is going to send this one over towards Witten. Witten looking to break that program record, still now tied for the lead. As Gomez is going to slow this one down, give it over towards Baker. 30 seconds left on that clock. It's the Eagles working on their passing on offense a little bit right now. Witten over towards Vietz. Vietz finds Baker. And Baker just simply slowing it down now, under 10 seconds. We'll see if the Eagles try to get a shot off here or just drain that clock down. Witten to Benoit, and that will run out that clock in the first quarter as the Eagles play a little bit of pass out there on offense to close out that one. We'll be back in just 2 minutes. The Eagles are up 8-0. Don't go anywhere. This is the Husson Eagles Sports Network.
Choosing a school is really difficult, but I have never felt like I should have gone somewhere else.
The thing about I like about the school, the class sizes are smaller.
Making friends is easier here because of the fact that you are such a tight-knit community.
I was shooting around a basketball. That's how I met my first friend.
You meet a lot of new people from different areas of the world.
I feel like I've grown so much here.
And there's so many amazing people that work here to learn from.
I definitely made the right decision coming to Husson.
If you want a place where you can be seen as an individual and know what you're doing and have a career to look forward to, this is your place.
And back here on the Husson Eagles Sports Network, I'm Avery Henningsen alongside Sam Miller. The Eagles lead this one 8-0 early on in this contest as they have had the dominant share of offense to start out this one. And we'll see what the Eagles choose to do in this second quarter of play as obviously getting out to that 8-0 lead early on in this one. It gives Coach DeHays a little bit of a chance to kind of get some in-game practice out there, sort of say, that you can work on some plays against tougher opponents like Maine Maritime later on in the season.
Absolutely, Avery. It looks like she's going with a lot of her bench right now. And let's see if we see a lot more of the same as we did in that first quarter. Husson really controlled the pace of the game, just spent, I think, a majority of the first quarter on offense. So let's see how Linda responds from here on out. This.
And it will be Gomez against Mack here in the middle of the field. We'll see what the Eagles decide to do. As this one's going to get popped up right towards Benoit, though. And she'll scoop that one up cleanly. Trying to take this one inside. She's going to send a pass over towards Vietz. Vietz into Baker. Vietz is going to take this one around the back side of the goal now. She tries to fit a pass into Lauer. She does. Gomez up to Benoit. Benoit finds Lengel as the Eagles continue to work on some movement on offense right now. This is Baker with the ball. She's going to send one over towards Doran. Doran make a little move to the backside, tries to find Vietz. She does. Vietz chooses to take this one back out to the top of the offense. Benoit to Vietz. Vietz working against the defender out there. Sends one over towards Benoit. The Eagles continue to work on that offensive ball movement out there.
Yeah, it looks like Lyndon is picked up their defensive intensity a little bit, making it a little harder for the Eagles to look for a good shot.
I think also the Eagles up 8 already in this one with a comfortable lead, kind of working on some stuff out there as they're going to give that one away off of the shot penalty on that one as the shot clock ran out. But the Eagles definitely working some stuff on offense. Didn't even try a shot attempt there. I think they had several out there, but more just trying to work on those fundamentals out there on offense. And I think also a little bit of friendly team or friendly conference camaraderie out there. They don't want to run this score up at all. Obviously, they got out to that early 8-0 lead.
Sure.
If you keep that up over four quarters, it'd be a 32-0 game, which you never want to see that out there on the field. But the Eagles right now just working on passing it, trying to get an open shot in the middle as a missed pass there. We'll give possession over towards the Hornets, and then we'll see if they can get this one out on defense. As I don't think this Husson defense has done a whole lot in this one.
Yeah, for majority of the game, most of the Husson defenders have just been on the other side of the field, just standing, biding their time, just taking it easy.
Yeah, I'm sure goalkeeper McGinn has had a nice little nice center stage viewing point for this one. She's just kind of watching that offense pass the ball around up there. This one's sent over to Lauer. Lauer to Baker. Baker is going to lose that one in the middle, but have enough time to scoop it back up. And she'll get fouled out there, and I'm sure on this one, you can't exactly have her just pass it. I wouldn't be surprised if she takes a shot on this one. As Baker's going to take this one inside. Off the goalkeeper, though, on that one, as she goes, I think, right off of her shin.
It looked like she was looking to go low there, but credit to Rachel Palladino when the goal is standard ground and good position right there to stop the goal.
And this one will be picked up by Vietz, passed over to Gomez. Gomez finds Lengel in the middle of the field. It's a pass from Benoit into the middle to Vietz. Has Gomez with it now. Gomez is going to send it back up top to Lengel. Lengel to Benoit. As the Eagles continue to just kind of pass this one around right at the top of the key. As Baker's going to send this to Gomez. As Gomez gets it knocked away on that one. We'll see. I saw a penalty whistle blown on that one.
Yeah, it looked like number 10, Libby Webb for the Hornets, kind of got Gomez from the back there. So they'll give an extra possession to the Eagles.
And Gomez will get a chance at a free position attempt on this one. Already at 2 goals in this game. Gomez is going to go left at the goalkeeper and go low left on her. And that will be 9-0 now in this contest.
Look back at this replay, Avery. We said it once. We said it 1,000 times. The impact that Gomez has had for this Eagles team has been nothing short but exceptional. Look at her just explode off the line. Finds the crease right there for the goal. And helps extend this Eagles lead.
And that will be a 9-0 lead now for the Eagles as Gomez gets her hat trick in this one. Will be her 20th goal of the season. And her 50th of her career as well. She hits a nice little important milestone on that one.
Yeah, it looks like she's just trying to go out in style here for her last home game on senior day.
As Gomez will be up against Mack in the middle of the field here as Eagles substitute a few players back out there. Martinez back onto the field, as well as Witten, along with Heth and Carrier on defense. And this will be a pass over towards Doran on the far side. Doran finds Martinez. Martinez up top to Gomez, who finds Witten. It's a missed pass there in the middle, but the Eagles still with plenty of time to scoop that one back up. As Lyndon, really no other choice other than to just kind of pack it in defensively. Be Langle over towards Witten. And Martinez with it to Witten.
It's like you mentioned earlier, Avery, it just looks like the Eagles are just going over some offensive plays here now. You see a lot of motion cuts across the middle as Martinez banks it off the goal. We're just seeing a lot of moving around for the Eagles, just working on their fundamentals. So we'll see how Lyndon responds.
As Martinez will get a card on that one. Four, I think she took a shot right into one of the Lyndon defenders. And the Eagles will be a woman down technically out there. There'll be a player down on the stat sheet, three players up on the field. And it will be Lyndon ball right in the middle of the field. They're going to try to take this one up offensively. It'll be Mack who's going to pick that one up for Lyndon. She runs into a wall of Husson defenders, but manages to kind of part through them as Lyndon, first time on offense in a while.
Yeah, notice how, despite the score, the Eagles' defensive intensity has not dipped at all.
That one will be given away and picked up by Lauer. Lauer finds Witten, who's wide open all alone. That one finds its way past her, but enough time for her to scoop that one back up. Witten over towards Doran. Doran finds Langle with some room in front of her. And that will be number 10, Libby Webb, who's going to foul Langle out there. And Langle will get a free position attempt on this one. And she's going to take this one towards the middle and go left post with it to get her second goal of this contest for the Eagles. That will be 10-0. And we'll be now running clock for the remainder of this game.
Yeah, take a look back at that replay, Avery. Libby Webb got Langle with that hit, which allows the free possession. Langle, with her size and length advantage over most of those players in that field, takes it high, puts it in for the Eagles.
And that will be 10-0 now for the Eagles in this one. As they've kind of really just been passing the ball around, as you can see that clock draining down, 7:35 left in the second quarter. And Mack will go into the middle for this draw control against Gomez. As this one's going to get popped up, sent into the middle. And I think Vietz is going to get called for the foul on that one.
Martinez back into the game now for the Eagles.
There'll be Bourgeois with the ball on offense for Lyndon. Gives it over towards Mack. Mack tries to send a pass into Webb. She does. Webb going up the middle, making a nice couple little cuts. As this Eagles defense finally gets a little bit more engaged in the game. This will be a pass up to Mac. Mac gives a ball over towards Krull. Onto the backside now for Lyndon. They take a shot over the top of Begin Stick, and that will be 10-1. 10-1 after that shot there from Lyndon as they get the first one of this contest.
Yeah, that was a pretty wonky possession right there for both teams. It didn't really, as soon as the shot went up, both referees were looking at each other to see if it went in. But nonetheless, it looks like it'll be a goal for Isabel Bourgeois.
And that was Lyndon's first shot of the game in that one. And they capitalized on that shot. I'm sure that Husson defense, having kind of just stood still for most of that game, might have been a little bit, not rusty out there, but sort of just kind of stiff. You've just been standing still watching the offense do their thing for 25-odd minutes out there.
If you're Lyndon, that's going to feel good. That means you're 1-for-1 in the game, shooting 100% on the goal.
This will be popped up, one by Gomez. As Martinez will take the ball up the middle of the field now for the Eagles. She'll send a pass over towards Witten. Witten to Lauer. Back over to Gomez, who finds Vietz out there. Vietz sends a pass right off of Witten's stick. As there'll be a missed pass from Gomez to Vietz. It looks like she's going to have enough time to pick that one up on that far end line. As Vietz is going to take this one herself all the way back into the middle of the field.
Husson really slowing things down in the second quarter. Obviously, with a 9-point lead over the Hornets, not really looking to run that score.
The Eagles still content to just work on a few things on offense. 10 seconds left on that shot clock. We'll see if they take a shot here with not much time. Martinez going inside. She's going to lose it. Just take it out herself. She'll get fouled on that one with 1 second left on that shot clock, and she'll get a free position attempt here coming up for the Eagles. Martinez is going to take this one to the right side of the goal and not get that one off in time on the free position attempt.
Yeah, Martinez had the right idea. She ran right to the goal, found her spot, but too little too late, and here come the Hornets.
It's a tough test there for Martinez with only 1 second on that clock. You don't really have enough time to really even get a shot off. As it'll be Witten here sending over towards Doran. Gomez with the ball. She's going to send it up top to Vietz, back to Witten. As Benoit sends this one over to Gomez. As Witten's going to try to fit a pass into Benoit, she does. Benoit hangs on to that one for just a second too long. I think that one got caught in the end of her stick.
Yeah, it was a good look from Benoit. She had a clear lane to the goal. Got where she needed to go, but just overshot it by a long shot.
And the Hornets will try to take this one up the left side on offense here. It'll be Doran and Lauer coming off for Baker and Romatzik. Martinez with the ball on the far sideline, or the far end line, that is. And this one will be passed up to the top of the field. Witten finds Romatzik. She gets it jarred loose there in the middle of the field. As Gomez is going to slow this one down right at the top. Witten drives inside herself, but slows it back down and takes it out. I think that one there, in maybe a normal situation, Witten might have taken that one herself if she had some room towards that right post.
Yeah, absolutely, Avery. But, you know, obviously with the score as high as it is right now, really no need to run up the score. This Eagles just seem to be passing the ball around.
As Baker takes one off the crossbar there, Gomez gets the rebound, picks it back up. Shot clock resets on that one, and they'll have 55 seconds and counting. 1:56 left on the game clock in this first half. As Romatzik will send this into Vietz. Vietz up top to Benoit. Benoit finds Witten. She sends it into Gomez. Gomez gets pushed out wide by the Hornets. As Witten sends a little pass over the top to Benoit, and that will be that record there for Natalie Witten on the pass to Benoit.
Going back to that last play, Avery, of course, what a great milestone for Witten. Gets the ball, views the field, and you see Benoit coming across the middle and just finds that left post and helps extend the Seagulls' lead.
As Witten sets that program record with 29 now on the season for the Eagles. The Eagles, obviously, with still a couple more games to play in the regular season, as Witten has really been doing it all for them offensively.
Absolutely, Avery. Not only for passing, she's a great scorer as well, but as the old saying goes, sharing is caring, and she's definitely done so over the course of her career with the Eagles.
22 goals on the season, along with 29 assists, will give her 51 points for the Eagles, as she's been dominant both passing and shooting out there on offense. You often see a lot of players who, like, they'll either do one or the other. They'll either be a very good scorer or a really good passer, but not always you see a really good passer and a really good shooter out there.
Yeah. Eagles have really got fortunate with someone like Witten on their team. Really has an impact whenever she's out there.
And that will be the end of the first half. The Eagles are up 11-1 after two halves of play. We'll be back in about 10 minutes here on the Husson Eagles Sports Network for that second half. Don't go anywhere. And back here on the Husson Eagles Sports Network, the Eagles are up 11-1 in this contest. It will be running clock for the foreseeable future unless Lyndon were able to score a second goal in this one and bring it back to a 9-goal deficit. They are on offense here. And it will be Mac with possession of it. She seems to be the dominant force on offense for Lyndon. And that will be a foul there on Veets. And Lyndon will get a chance to take a free position shot here right from the middle. The Bourgeois, the goal scorer from before. That one saved there by Begin. And she's going to send a wide open pass all the way up top to Gomez. The Eagles in transition here have numbers. But we kind of saw in that second quarter, they seem content to really just kind of pass it around on offense right now.
Yeah, they really slowed down that pace once they ran up the scoreboard a little bit. So I'm sure we'll see more of the same here in the second half.
It'll be interesting to see if they continue. They had a couple of shot clock violations in that first half where the shot clock just kind of ran out. We'll see if they choose to kind of pass it around for a while, and then maybe that final 15, 20 seconds are kind of a green light go out there for the offense and let them still kind of stay engaged out there. You don't want them to just kind of pass around the whole time. You'd like to get a few shots off out there.
Of course, and it really seemed like, besides a couple of goals, a lot of their goals from that second quarter came from a free possession.
Yeah, I think the Eagles, barring a getting fouled there in the middle, will probably just kind of pass this one around and continue draining this clock down as that one bounces its way to Benoit. Benoit over the top to Lengel, doesn't manage to keep possession of it. And it will be Paladino who's going to pick that one up in goal. She's done a great job in this one for Lyndon so far, as she has 9 saves in this one, obviously allowed the 11 goals, but she's faced quite a few shots already to start off this game. 30 shots in that first 2 quarters of play out there. And I would think a lot of those, yeah, 24 of those coming in that first quarter.
Yeah, from the very get-go, Husson has the Eagles have very much dictated the pace of this game. I mean, as soon as that first quarter ended, I mean, I'm sure fatigue must be setting in for the Hornets right now. So keeping up with this fast Eagles team is no easy feat, especially being down in this past year.
Yeah, and a lot also with the Eagles, just kind of seems like they're working on their offensive movement out there, just kind of players moving every which way. It's forcing Lyndon, that is, to... They can't just kind of stay in one spot because there's players moving all around. You kind of have to follow them.
That's what the Eagles excel at as well, Avery. They love to move around. They love to cut across the middle, work their way around behind the goal, cause some movement in this Eagles offense.
And Benoit will pass that one over towards Whitten. Whitten's going to send it into Gomez. Gomez finds Veets, who finds Benoit, who takes that shot for the Eagles as she gets the green light on that one. A nice shot there on that one from Benoit. She caught that one cleanly on the run, took it into that upper right-hand corner.
Yeah, going back to this replay, Avery, right on cue. We mentioned how the Eagles like to cut. We see Benoit come across the middle, fires it in there, and extends this Eagles lead.
As the Eagles have done a good job today of spreading around, you have goals from Baker, Lauer, Benoit, Gomez, Wynn, Lengel, and Veets out there. Most of that whole offense, barring a couple players, have netted one in this game. And it will be Gomez versus Mac here in the middle. And Gomez is going to come away with that one. As Lengel in this game getting her first start of the season with 2 goals and 2 assists out there for the Eagles. Benoit over towards Veets. Beats finds Gomez, who sends it back to Benoit.
Notice the system of the Eagles' offense right now. It just seems like every time someone gets the ball at the top, another person comes right through the middle, goes to the left, goes behind the goal. Constant motion here for the Eagles.
Well, they're definitely doing a great job, like you mentioned, of just kind of having constant movement out there. If you can have those players that cross across the defense, it can be so dangerous because then it just one player gets out of position, then another kind of player can drop into that gap just created and give the Eagles a better shooting chance out there.
Absolutely.
As this will be passed to Lengel. Lengel back to Lauer, who's going to catch it, take a shot off the goalkeeper there on that one. As a couple players go flying on that one, but Gomez is going to be the one who's going to scoop it up for the Eagles. It's very nearly, Lauer almost got her second goal of the game.
Yeah, Lengel really put it up there for her. She had to go up there and try to get that ball. And when she got up there, and right on cue.
And Lauer gets her second of the game as she takes that pass in the middle and shoots it home for the Eagles.
Yeah, what right on cue, Avery, as you mentioned, Lauer just missing that goal just by a smidge. Gets redemption right here. Flips it right in for the Eagles as they are pouring on this lead against Lyndon.
As it is now 13-1 in this contest. It'll be Witten and Doran along with Lengel coming off for Martinez, Baker, and Romatzik out there for the Eagles. As be Gomez in the middle waiting for that one. So now 8 minutes and counting. That running clock kind of just keeps this game moving right along. There'll now be 8 minutes left in this third quarter play. And it seems like the Eagles have had a little bit more of the green light to take some shots in this third quarter, Sam.
Yeah, it looks like it. I mean, in that second quarter, they definitely slowed things down and have just decided to just pass the ball around. But they've been a little more active in shots they've been taking in this third quarter.
And it will be Baker with the ball now. She's going to slow it down back over to Martinez. Martinez finds Vietz out there. As a senior-to-senior connection on the field, Martinez, or Vietz, that is, to Gomez. Gomez over towards Martinez. As the Eagles continue to just kind of move the ball back and forth, it seems like they're having a little movement around here as you have one player drop in, one player come back out to the top, and just that same kind of one player looping around the backside while another one comes in to find him. This one's sent into Baker.
Absolutely.
Sorry to cut you off.
Absolutely, Avery. That's just the well-oiled machine that is the Eagles' offense, which makes them tough for any contender in this North Atlantic Conference.
The Eagles in obviously, they're in a kind of a three-team race right now for that top spot in the North Atlantic Conference, along with Maine Maritime and SUNY Canton out there. The Eagles will be playing Maine Maritime next weekend, and that will be a big game in terms of playoff seeding as well as regular season seeding out there to see how the Eagles can do in that one.
Yeah, that'll be a treat for sure. Both teams play so similar. They like to move around. They love to pass. They're in for a treat for that one.
Maine Maritime, obviously, with the offensive force that is Hazel Stoddard. As Baker's going to take a shot right over the top there, but Hazel Stoddard, player for Maine Maritime, who's obviously last season had a insane rookie of the year season where she had 87 goals. And this year, she's kind of right on track for that one as I believe she's averaging around 4 to 5 goals per game, which over a full season of play is kind of wild out there. But she's someone that the Eagles kind of managed to lock up for a lot of that game that they played against them earlier.
Absolutely, Avery. And it's like we mentioned with Avery Baker the other day, like when you're as talented as players like that are, you are not only are you just a primary target, you're just public enemy number one in terms of on the lacrosse pitch. So most of the defensive attention is going to be focused on that player. And it really just goes to show like how talented those people are when your entire defensive game plan revolves around that singular player.
And looking at the live stats for the SUNY Canton Maine Maritime game going on right now, Canton is leading that one 11-5 in the third quarter right now. So they're kind of handing it to them a little bit. The Baker pass over the top, trying to find, I believe that's Benoit out there, and she's going to eventually come away. They got knocked down, but still the Eagles with possession of the ball.
Got a smattering of substitutions coming in for the Eagles. We have number 14, Natalie Wooden, coming in along with Doran.
As Martinez takes a shot over her back shoulder on that one, kind of falling away from the goal. I'm not sure if the goalkeeper could even see her on that one.
Yeah, taking a look at that replay right here. We know Martinez, she's very, very scrappy and speedy player, a deadly combination here on the pitch. Takes that ball inside, flips it right in, as the Eagles just continue this this offensive clinic they're putting up against the Hornets.
And another goal scorer there for the Eagles. As that was Martinez getting that one. Lyndon will take a timeout. Probably try to get a little bit of a breather out there. We'll take one, too. Eagles are up 14-1 on the Husson Eagles Sports Network.
Nothing runs like a deer.
Whether you have a lawn to mow, a driveway to plow, or a garden to till, our customers know you can't beat the quality and reliability of a John Deere.
And right now at Greenway Equipment Sales, we have a great offer for you.
Get 0% APR fixed rate financing for 72 months on a John Deere compact utility tractor with a 6-year powertrain warranty.
For more offers, go to greenwayequipment.com.
See the Smith brothers today at Greenway Equipment Sales, Ellsworth and Bangor.
And back here at Boucher Field, out of the timeout, the Eagles lead this one by 13, 14-1 over top of Northern Vermont Lyndon out there. And it was Martinez who scored a goal right before that timeout from Lyndon. And Bourgeois will foul Gomez out there, and the Eagles will be working on offense again.
Credit to the Hornets, though, as down as they might be right now, they are out there fighting, putting up some defensive pressure, just trying to get something going here in this game. Got to respect that.
And it will be Carrier with the ball on offense now, as it looks like the Eagles might have moved a couple of their defenders up to that offensive side of the ball. I see Whidden and Doran on defense for the Eagles right now. and it's kind of every defender's dream out there. They don't get a lot of offensive possessions out there, but they'll get a chance here in this one. The Eagles up big already to try to get a few shots on goal out there. As it'll be Baker with the ball over towards Lingle. Lingle finds Gomez. It'll be Vietz inside to Baker. Baker going herself, gets it knocked away, poked. But I think she's going to have enough time to scoop that one up. There'll be a whistle, though, over on that far side.
Yeah, great offensive possession there for the Eagles. Baker got where she wanted to go, but credit to the defense of number 10, Libby Webb, for the Hornets, knocking that ball away.
And it'll be Baker with a very short angle free position attempt on this one. She's going to take it herself right over the top of the goalkeeper. She gets knocked down there, but the score for the Eagles, 15-1 now.
Going back to that replay really quick, it's just something we've come to see from Baker this entire season. Coming right from that angle, as Avery said, just attacks and floats right in there for the goal and pushes this Eagle lead up to 14.
And that will be the third goal of Avery Baker's game here today, 35th on the season for the freshman. That is 41 points for her in her rookie year.
Yeah, it seemed like for a while, Avery, especially in that SUNY Kanto game yesterday, she's been in a bit of a dry spell. So must feel good for her to get some of her mojo back in this game.
Yeah, she had a couple goals in the fourth quarter of that one as that SUNY Kanto defense loosened up a little bit out there. A lot of teams have been trying to man mark her a lot, which can be difficult, especially in women's lacrosse, as you can't be quite as physical on offense out there. This will be Mac over towards Bourgeois. She sends a pass over the top as a just kind of hit there, as I don't even think she really had full possession of it. That was number 18, Alexis Leroy, out there. We'll see what the referees say on this one, as I don't think she really even had full possession of it. I think they're going to call her for a dangerous shot attempt on that one. So it will no be goal, or it won't be a goal there for Leroy.
Yeah, it looks like when she checked in that pass from, I believe it was number 11, Weisauer, she ended up batting the ball when didn't have full control of it, which is hence the call from the referees.
And begin, we'll send this one over towards Heth. Heth with some time here to pass this one over towards Witten. And that's what it looks like when you have an offensive player who's known for her stick work on defense. She can take those smooth little passes and take it right up the middle for the Eagles. This one will be passed over, and the clock will run out in this third quarter. The Eagles are up 15-1 in this one as they continue to pour on the offense. We'll be back in just a minute or two here on the Husson Eagles Sports Network.
Choosing a school is really difficult, but I have never felt like I should have gone somewhere else.
The thing about I like about the school, the class sizes are smaller.
Making friends is easier here because of the fact that you are such a tight-knit community.
I was shooting around a basketball. That's how I met my first friend.
You meet a lot of new people from different areas of the world.
I feel like I've grown so much here.
And there's so many amazing people that work here to learn from.
I definitely made the right decision coming to Husson.
She
Choosing a school is really difficult, but I have never felt like I should have gone somewhere else.
The thing about I like about the school, the class sizes are smaller.
Making friends is easier here because of the fact that you are such a tight-knit community.
I was shooting around a basketball. That's how I met my first friend.
You meet a lot of new people from different areas of the world.
I feel like I've grown so much here.
There's so many amazing people that work here to learn from.
I definitely made the right decision coming to Husson.
And back here on the Husson Eagles Sports Network, the Eagles are up 15-1 in this one. As we enter the fourth quarter of play, running clock has kept this game moving right along out there. As looks like the Eagles have put sophomore defender Sydney Heth up top now as Coach DeHaze continues to try to get her defense some offensive possession out there.
It looks like number 24, Jory Board, seen some time for the first time in this game.
As this one will be sent over towards Martinez. It'll be Boyd and Carrier, two of the defenders up top there. As you have three offensive players for the Eagles on defense right now. We'll see if the Eagles try to get one of those two the ball out there. As it will be sent over towards Martinez. Carrier with the ball now. She's going to pass this one over towards V2. Nice little bit of stick work there to hang on to that one.
Yeah, it's really extended right there to hold on to that pass.
Boyd up to Booth. Booth, another one of those defenders out there on offense for the Eagles. As Gomez gets the green light, takes it to the right side, and buries into that lower left-hand corner for the Eagles. I think Gomez, one of those seniors with the green light to just kind of take a shot attempt if she has it.
You know, just as you said, Avery, Gomez just having every opportunity to score here. Sophia Gomez, have a day for you. The senior day for your last senior regular season game here for the Eagles.
Gomez up to four in this one. 21 on the season, 51 over her career here at Husson.
Really decided to go out in style for her last game.
As it will be Gomez up against Mack here in the middle of the field for this draw control. As this one will be won by Mac out there.
Mac has been really the motor for this somewhat lackluster Lyndon offense. Like whenever she gets the ball, we see her get hounded by Eagle defenders.
And I just saw Boyd streak back from that offensive side of the ball. I think they still want those offensive players who are in the midfield to come back up and play a little bit of defense out there. Will be a foul there on Vietz, and will be a free position attempt coming up here for, I believe that's number 26 out there, Mika Krul. She's going to take one from deep, scooped up and saved by Begin. She's going to lob one up top towards Lauer, well past her head. This one's bouncing. I don't think this one's going to have enough of a little bit of traction to slow down. It will go out of bounds, but the Eagles still playing some defense out there. As Max going to knock the stick out of Booth's hand there. And Booth will take this one up the right side for the Eagles.
Once again, we're seeing the Eagles just pass the ball around, looking to maybe run down that shot clock a little bit, work on their fundamentals. And we see Benoit standing back a little far, usually very involved in the offense. This goes to show like how the Eagles are slowing things down.
Yeah, Benoit, one of those three offensive players who the Eagles have just kind of put back on defense, letting some of their defensive players get some offensive minutes out there. It will be Martinez up top to Lauer. Booth inside to Gomez now. As the Eagles continue to just kind of pass this one around. This will be sent up top to Vietz now. Vietz tries to send one into Carrier, but defender's on her hip. And that one will get turned over towards Lyndon. It'll be Webb with it, taking around the backside of the goal. But she meets a Husson defender out there on the far sideline. Probably nice for Boyd to be able to play a little bit of open field defense. I think she's used to having that goal right behind her out there. And it'll be Vietz coming away with it. She's going to send it over the top of Benoit's head. This one will be picked up out there by Lyndon. And some boxing out in the middle of the field there. You know, Benoit used to play basketball in high school, and it came through right there on that one as she boxed out the defender and got that ball back for the Eagles.
Yeah, there was a little scrum right there for the ball. It looked like it was Bourgeois out there trying to go up against Vietz and Benoit, and which is now resulting in the possession for the Eagles.
And that will be a pass into the stick of Carrier out there. Carrier trying to work her way inside, pushed away by Lyndon, though. And it will be Martinez with the ball on the backside. She's going to try to fit a pass into Booth. Booth, I know, scored 3 goals last season. She has a little bit of offensive scoring in her past here at Husson. I know she played a little bit more of a forward defensive role last year rather than in this season, where she's kind of locked into one of those 4 deep back defenders who stay out there.
Yeah, which makes it really nice when you have an opportunity like this, when you're out big and you get a chance to showcase your offensive ability.
This one's sent into Carrier. Carrier's going to try to work her way inside. Gets it jarred loose. This one finds Vietz. Over to Gomez. And this one will be in the stick of Booth out there. There'll be now 8 minutes and counting here left in this fourth quarter.
Saw Boyd in the left-hand corner trying to make a move against, I believe it was Libby Webb. Great effort there from Webb to kind of lock her up.
And Martinez sends a pass over the head of Boyd out there. As Lyndon will try to send this one up the field towards Weisauer.
And despite the one-sided affair we've seen on the scoreboard, whenever Lyndon seems to get a hold of the ball, Husson is just absolutely ruthless on defense, Avery.
They've done a great job in transition. This one haven't really allowed that many clearance attempts by Lyndon. as this one is kind of popped up to that far side. It'll be Mack going up the middle of the field now for Lyndon. As Lyndon is only 2 of 23 in clearance attempts in this game against this Eagles midfield that is very dangerous out there.
Yeah, as we mentioned, like Husson not making it easy for Lyndon to, for many transition opportunities here on offense. Just every time they seem to get something going, they just build that wall that is their exceptional midfield defense.
And it will be Romatic and Scanlon coming on for the offense as Carrier and Booth exit the field out there. As a shot clock violation there from Lyndon will give the ball back over to the Eagles. And there'll be a little bit of a referee conference out there on the field as they discuss what's happening out there. But it's been an interesting game out there as the Eagles have kind of used this one as a little bit of a practice sort of warm-up game before that big Maine Maritime game next weekend. They've worked on a lot of things offensively, given some players some minutes in areas that they might not normally have played in.
Absolutely, Avery. And if you're the Hornets in a situation like this, probably not enough time to mount a miraculous comeback, barring some sort of miracle. As of right now, just I would do what Husson is doing right, and just work on the fundamentals, try to get some good goals if possible, and we'll see where things go from here. Credit to the Hornets, though. Despite being down, they've been working tirelessly since the very get-go. Offensively and defensively, keeping up with the smattering of goals provided from the Eagles.
And be a conference on the sideline between the referees and coaches out there. As I'm not 100% sure what the mix-up is out on the field. I think it probably had something to do with that shot clock timer that went out there. Nonetheless, it'll be Dorn in the far corner for the Eagles. She's going to send a pass up the middle. And it looks like it's going to find its way to Scanlon. Did a nice job stepping in front of that one over towards Lauer. As with 5 minutes left, I think we could potentially see the Eagles try to be a little bit more aggressive on offense out there. We'll see. As Veet sends this one up to Scanlon. Scanlon over to Lauer, back to Gomez. As this will be Romatic with it now. Gomez looking still for that fifth goal in this one. She's obviously been very dominant out there offensively for the Eagles. As this one will be passed to the backside Veets now. Veet spits one inside to Romatic, who can't quite manage to get control of that one right in front of the goal.
Yeah, good look there from Veet. She saw Romatic coming in right down the middle. Just couldn't get it in there.
And be a turnover there on the backside. It'll be in the goalkeeper's stick, it looks like, out there. Paladino with 10 saves in this one. And she'll give this one over to Mac in the backside of the crease out there. This one's going to get scooped up by Weishauer. She's going to try to take it up the right side. Stopped by the Eagles, though, as they almost take that one away. There'll be a penalty on that one, and the Eagles will have possession on the far end line. Under 4 minutes left and counting in this one. be a pass up to Vietz. Vietz finds Gomez. Gomez does a little move inside, but nothing there for her. She's got a whole bunch of room right in front of the net there, but chooses to just kind of let that clock continue draining down.
Yeah, I'll probably see more of that for the rest of the game. No need to run up the score when you're already up by so much. I'll probably just keep seeing a lot of passing and more fundamentals from the Eagles offense from here on out.
Be Lengel over to Scanlon. They pass into Lauer, and she gets that one. Her hat trick in this one. 3 goals for her in the first start of her young career.
Yeah, going back to that last play, Avery, as you said, hat trick for Maddie Lauer, the freshman out of Winslow High School. It's a great pass from, I believe it was Lengel, and fed it right in for a 3rd goal of the game.
Yeah, the Eagles now with Avery Baker at 3, Madison Lauer at 3, Maddie Benoit at 2, Sophia Gomez at 4, Layla Martinez at 1, Natalie Witten at 1, Jordan Lengel at 2, and Devin Vietz at 1 as they've spread it all around that offense. It's not been just one player here today. Obviously, Gomez with the advantage in goals scored, but it's done a great job out there for the Eagles as it'll be Lengel in the middle here for this draw control. As it looks like it will be a draw control violation on that one. Looks like Lyndon's sending everybody on this one as the whole offense starts to move up the field. It's Mack with the ball now here as Lyndon will probably have a chance for one last maybe shot on goal on this one. Mack over towards Weisauer out there. Back to Mack. Mack fits one in over the top, knocked away there by Heth. We'll see if the penalty is on her or if it's on Lynn. It looks like it'll be on number 7, Sydney Heth, out there. And this will be a fine opportunity here for Bourgeois to try to get a shot off here. And she takes one low, saved by Begin out there, and scooped up by Boyd.
Yeah, it was good. Go back to that last play, Avery. It was good. Pressure there from Heth, tried to get that ball, but then unfortunately, Scott hit that penalty with a free possession. Here come the Eagles.
And Boyd tries to send one over towards Scanlon, under 45 seconds left on that clock, as it will be picked up by Lyndon out there. Webb with it now, trying to work it up the field, sends it back to Mack. Sure, Lyndon will be content to run this clock down and just kind of get out of here a little bit, as they're under 30 seconds now. That will be a foul on Gomez. I think she got a high stick on that one. Mack's going to send a pass over the top, too high there. As Doran is going to eventually come away with it. She sends it over to Baker, and that will end the game for the Eagles as they will win this contest 17-1 over Northern Vermont Lyndon. Lyndon will drop to 0-7 on the season, 0-2 in conference play, while the Eagles will move to 7-4, 3-1 in conference play. They'll be looking forward to that big Maine Maritime matchup next weekend. I'm going to take a quick look over at that Maine Maritime SUNY Canton game. That SUNY Canton is currently leading 16-10 at the start of that fourth period. We'll be all eyes on that final score. If Canton were to win that one, they would probably be in the driver's seat to get that number one seed in the North Atlantic Conference. Maine Maritime to win it, it would still be open book for all these teams to try to get that top seed in the conference. But this will be the final women's lacrosse matchup here of the regular season on the Husson Eagles Sports Network. I've been Avery Henningsen alongside Sam Miller. Thank you for joining us. Have a good rest of your weekend.